In this Chief Architect X12 What's New video segment, I'm going to show off our new design-oriented features. Let's begin by looking at the new Tray Ceiling tool. Tray ceilings can be created automatically. When you select a room, there is a new Tray Ceiling tool. You can define the width, depth, pitch, and if the tray recesses into the ceiling. There is a panel to control rope lighting for LED lights and a panel to add moldings for vertical style ceilings. Once a custom ceiling is created, the resulting ceiling polyline can be edited, customized, and unblocked to individual components with an explode tool. Tray ceilings can also be nested one over the other. For ceiling moldings, you can specify the distance of the molding vertical offset from the ceiling as well as from the floor. Room molding defaults have been added for rooms. For example, you can now exclude a base molding for a bathroom or include a crown molding for an office room. Moldings can be rotated using the new Rotate Profile feature on the Moldings panel within the relevant dialogs to change their installation orientation. The Delete Objects tool has a new Walls category and has been expanded to include several new items. Removing unused wall types, layers, CAD blocks, and line styles is a quick process with the new Delete All Unused tool in the respective dialogs. When you convert an object to a custom symbol, you can choose the item's name before adding it to the library. For architectural blocks, such as this bathroom vanity, you can use the Add to Library As to add all the individual elements of the object to the library. A Find in Library tool is available to help you determine where a selected object may exist in the library. The search allows you to filter based on the object and its materials. Roof pivot controls in the diagram have been added to the general panel of the roof dialog. You can adjust the diagram for rafters or trusses. The roof can be locked at various locations, making it easy to control how the roof will pivot as you make changes. For U and L-shaped stairs, there is added control to create winders and to split landings into multiple segments. Stairs can be moved individually or as a group. The default is to move the stairs together as a grouping. You can use the Alt key to move an individual stair segment or landing. You can also use the Alt key to disconnect the stair or landing. Stairs will bump into other stairs, ramps, and landings. There is a new Stringers panel in the Stair Specification dialog. For stringers, you can define the number, placement, and sizing. Using the custom stringers setting, you have advanced control over the stringers. Also new in this panel is control for the stair trim against the wall. You can define the height, thickness, and a setting to clip the trim top. On the material panel, you will notice new entries for risers, stringers, and wall trim. You can change these materials to be unique in this panel or from a 3D view. Breaks can be added to stairs and ramps. If you need to create a new stair segment on an existing stair, you can use the Break Edit tool. For example, on this stair segment, I can use the Break tool and create a complete break, and now I can resize this lower segment. Stairs of varying widths can be connected. If you have a wider stair segment that connects into a narrower stair segment, such as this stairway, you will find this to be an easier process. For walls, there is now a universal break tool found in the lower edit menu, just like all other objects. Wall caps can be assigned to pony walls, half walls, and now for full height and retaining walls. For railing walls, you can control the type of post for the start and end, including an auto post, half, full, or no post at all. Post offsets can also be defined for railings. For framing headers, you can specify a boxed option. Using a boxed header will create framing members above and below the header, as you can see in this elevation view. For all framing members, we have added an object information panel. In this panel, you can include details to be reflected in schedules and the materials list. Floor framing can be done on a per-room basis or for a group of rooms, similar to what exists for framing walls and roofs individually. For remodeling, this is a great way to frame only the new construction. When you frame a separate room, depending on your design, the program will ask if you want to create a room framing group. A framing group will keep the framing separate for the room. This framing group setting is located on the Structure panel of the Room dialog. The Trim and Extend CAD tools work with terrain elevation data, such as elevation lines. As you create or modify terrain lines, the Trim and Extend tools can facilitate faster and easier editing. There are several great new features in Chief Architect X12, and you can expect to see it in early 2020. And remember, all new software purchases include a year of support and software assurance. So, if you are not currently a customer, get started with Chief Architect today.